Hello students, how are you all? I'm sure you all must be doing great. Children, today we'll be continuing with the grammar portion and we'll start with a new topic, and the topic is adverbs. Before I explain to you what adverbs are, let us go through few sentences, okay? The first sentence, a camel walks slowly. Okay, so in this sentence, the sentence is about camel and it is telling us how a camel walks. A camel walks slowly. Okay, next, the boy waters the plants every day. Here, a boy waters the plant every day. It is telling you the frequency, that how often does the boy water the plants. The boy waters the plants every day. Does he water the plants every day? Does he water the plant once in a week or twice in a week or every alternate day? But here it is saying the boy waters the plants every day. It is telling you the frequency, how often a boy waters the plants. Okay, next, I met an old friend yesterday. When did I meet an old friend? Yesterday. So it is telling you the time, whether you met it yesterday, whether you met it an hour ago or 5 hours ago or last year. So here, yesterday is telling you the time when you met your old friend. So I met an old friend yesterday. Yesterday word is telling you when did you meet your friend. And the fourth sentence, the guest went upstairs in their room. Sorry, the guests. The guests went upstairs in their room. Where did the guests go? The guests went upstairs. Where did they go? Upstairs. Okay. In their room. They went to the next floor, to their room, which was on the next floor. So here, upstairs is telling you where the guests went. Okay, so words which tells you about a verb, something extra about a verb, it modifies the verb, it tells you where the action took place, when the action took place, or how frequently does the action takes place. So those kinds of words are called adverbs. So adverbs are words which tells you where, when, how often an action takes place. Where does an action take place? How often does an action take place? Or when the action takes place. Okay? Now there are many kinds of adverbs which we'll be doing one by one. The first adverb which we are going to do today is adverb of manner. Adverb of manner tells us how an action takes place. Okay? Or in what manner it is done. How an action takes place or in what manner. So basically, if you want to know whether a given adverb is an adverb of manner or not, you have to ask the question how. Okay. So for example, the baby cried loudly. So if we'll ask, if we'll make a question out of this sentence, what will we say? We will ask, how did the baby cry? So the question is how. So here, loudly word is telling you in what manner, in what way the baby cried. Did he cry softly or did he cry loudly? So here, loudly is adverb of manner. One more example. He comes to school punctually. Okay. Now in this question, in what manner does he come to school? How he comes to school? He comes to school punctually. Okay. So loudly, punctually, softly, ferociously, or strongly, these are adverbs of manner. Now, adverbs of manner are either placed immediately after the verb, like here, the baby cried loudly. Now, cried is the main verb. So sometimes adverb of manner is written immediately after the main verb. Sometimes in this sentence, now punctually is adverb of manner, okay, and comes is the main verb. But in this sentence, punctually is not written immediately after comes. It is written after school. So here, school is an object. So when it comes to adverb of manner are at times written immediately after the main verb, or it is written after the object. Okay? Some more words of adverb of manner is like carefully, carelessly. He does his work carefully. She does her work carelessly. Or suspiciously. The boy looked around suspiciously. Okay? Or, beautifully. She danced beautifully. So these are some of the words which comes under adverb of manner. Okay, the second adverb is adverb of place. Now you can easily understand words which tells you where the action takes place or has taken place or will take place. Those words are called, those words come under adverb of place. Okay, so if you want to ask something, we'll say where it happened. Okay, for example, it tells you adverb of place tells you where the action takes place. Okay, for example, my brother is sitting outside. Okay, if I ask the question, where is my brother sitting? So your answer will be, he is sitting outside. So this outside word is telling you where the brother is sitting. So this is adverb of place. Second one, the army marched forward. Where did the army march? It marched forward. That means, did it go ahead or did it go back? So here, forward is adverb of place. Okay, so words like outside, inside, okay, in front of, behind, okay, don't hide behind the almirah. So here, hide behind is the adverb of place. It is telling you where that hiding portion, hiding part will be done or is being done. So words which tells you where an action takes place comes under adverb of place. Some adverb of places are like here, there, everywhere, nowhere. I can't find my papers anywhere. Okay, or the sheets were scattered everywhere. Or you can also say, the boy was asked to come here. Yeah, I asked my friend to come here. So here, there, everywhere, nowhere, ahead, forward, behind. So these words tells you where the action takes place, and they come under adverb of place. The third kind of adverb is adverb of time. So words which tells you when, at what time an action took place, they comes under adverb of time. For example, I got up early today. Okay. So here, what is the adverb of time? There are two adverbs of time here, early also and today. So I got up early in the morning. And when did I get up in the morning? today, yesterday, when? One more example. The program is going to start soon. Okay, so when is the program going to start? Soon. It can be within 5 minutes or within 10 minutes or within few seconds. Okay, so here soon is telling you the adverb of time. When is the program going to start? Soon. Next, one more example. Mona will perform tomorrow. So when is Mona going to perform? Tomorrow. So words like now, today, tomorrow, yesterday, soon, nearly, lately, not nearly, sorry, lately. So these words are adverbs of time. These words tells you the time when an action is going to take place, and they come under adverb of time. The fourth kind of adverb is adverb of frequency. Now, adverb of frequency are words which tells you how often or in what frequency an action takes place. Okay. For example, you can say my mother goes to temple daily. So how often does my mother go to temple? How frequently my mother goes to temple? Daily, every day. You can say every day also. Okay. Another one. We pay income tax yearly. Okay, you don't pay it monthly. Monthly is like every month. Yearly is once in a month. Okay, so when you say we pay income tax yearly, so yearly is telling you how frequently, how often do you pay your income tax. Like you, when you go to school, you pay your monthly fees. Okay, so you can say we pay our tuition fees monthly. Every month you have to pay fees to your school, or you pay fees to your tutor. So that payment comes under monthly. So words like yearly, monthly, daily, quarterly, rarely, often, sometimes, these words tells you how often or how frequently a work is done. So they are adverbs of frequency. The fifth kind of adverb is adverb of degree. Adverb of degree tells you how much of an action or how much of a work is done. For example, he is quite rich. How rich he is? See, question is how rich he is? He is quite rich. Or one more example. The tea is too hot. Now, how is the tea? It is too hot. Now, T-O-O-2 means it is very hot. So, in place of too, we can also use very to show the degree of hotness. Okay, how hot a tea is? It is very hot, or it is too hot. One more question. Sorry, one more sentence we can say is, my work is almost, done. When you say my work is almost done, you are telling that it is about to finish. So here almost is telling you that how to what extent your work is done. It is almost more than have and it is not finished, but it is about to finish. So words like quite, too, very, almost, hardly, scarcely. So these words tells you the adverb of degree. So one, okay. So the sixth kind of adverb is interrogative adverbs. Now remember what is interrogative? Interrogative word is question words. So words which are asked to know a place of action or the time of action or the frequency of action or the degree of action. So those words come under adverb, comes under interrogative adverbs. For example, now some of the interrogative adverbs are how tells you the adverb of manner, okay, when, and these words are generally used to ask questions, so they are used at the beginning of the question, okay. So when tells you the time, okay, or where tells you the place, and one more is there, that is why, it tells you the reason, okay. So these words, how, when, where, and why, these words are interrogative adverbs which are used to ask questions when we want to know the place, the manner, the time, the frequency, or the degree, or the reason of the action done. For example, if we ask, if we say, how often do you pray? How often do you pray? Now it is an interrogative adverb, so always remember that you have to put a question mark after you have written the sentence, okay. So here how often is asking you the frequency. Do you pray daily? Do you pray once in a month? Do you pray weekly, once in a week? Okay, so this how often will tell you the frequency of the work. Second one, suppose we are using when. So here you can say, when did you finish your work? So when I want to know the time of the work, so I'll use this interrogative adverb, when. When did you finish your work? Did you finish it now? Did you finish it 2 hours back? Did you finish it yesterday? Okay, so these, so when I want to know the time of the work done, then we use when. Okay, next one is where. Where tells you when you want to know the place where the action took place, you use this word where. For example, where did the accident happen? So when I say where did the accident happen, that means I want to know whether the accident happened in a nearby spot, or did it happen in another town, or in another city, or in another country. Okay, so when we want to know the place of the action, then we use the interrogative adverb where. Okay, now last one is why. Now why we use when we want to know the reason. When we want to know the reason why an action took place, then we use the word why. For example, why were you crying? Now the action is what? Crying. You saw somebody crying and then you want to know the reason. Why are you crying? Did somebody hit you? Did you get hurt? Or are you feeling alone? What is the reason behind your crying? So when we want to know the reason, then we use the interrogative adverb why. Okay, once more, how is used when we want to know the manner of work done. When is used to know about the time of the work done. Where is used to know the place where the action takes place. And why is used when we want to know the reason behind that action. Okay, so all these words, how, when, where, and why, these are interrogative adverbs. The seventh kind of adverb is adverb of reason. Okay, so when a question starts with why did it happen? So when you are answering, you say what? It happened because, or it happened as, it happened since, or because he is because he is sick, he cannot go to school, or the man is blind, therefore he needs a help to cross the road. So such words like because, as, or so, or therefore, or since. So these words are adverb of reason because they are used when we are telling the reason why the action took place. For examples, now let me start with because. I am upset. Why am I upset? Because I lost my favorite pen. Why am I upset? So the reason of my being upset is that I lost my favorite pen. Similarly, as you can say, we decided to stay in a hotel. We decided to stay in a hotel. Why did you decide to stay in a hotel? As it was getting late at night. Or you can say as it was getting dark. Because the night was almost there, it was getting dark, so we decided to stay in the hotel. Okay, similarly, therefore, I have just said the man needs help. The man is blind, therefore he needs help to cross the road. Or since the man is blind, he needs help to cross the road. So these words comes under adverb of reason. Words which tells you the reason why an action has is to be done or needs to be done or has taken place, those words come under adverb of reason. Okay, class 7, this is your English grammar book, Radiant Grammar 7, and you have to do the exercises which are given on page number 48 and 49 of your grammar book. On page number 48, be part is there, in wherein there are words given in the purple box and you have to categorize them into adverb of time, adverb of place, adverb of frequency, adverb of manner and adverb of degrees. That means which of these words will come under each heading. So this is your work. And second one, these fill-ups, the blanks, you have to fill them up with adverbs. Okay, that adverb can be any of the kind of adverb depending upon the sentence. Okay, and the last one is here in this one, the D part, it's a jumbled up sentence in which adverb words are given, so you have to arrange these words in such a manner that they give a meaningful sentence. Okay, like I told you that adverb of manner, when you are using words of adverb of manner, they can be written immediately after the main verb or at times after the subject who is the recipient of the, or sorry, after the object which is the recipient of the action. Okay, so you have to do exercise number D also here. It is written here, rewrite these jumbled sentences placing the adverbs in the right order. Okay, so and on top here it is telling you adverb of manners are written either immediately after the verb or after the object, and adverb of place is like this also. Okay, all those are same. It can generally adverb of place is written after the main verb, and adverb of time is usually it is both way. Either it starts at the beginning of, it is used at the beginning of a sentence, like recently I met my best friend. Okay, or You can also say, yesterday I met my best friend. I can also say it, I met my best friend yesterday. That is also adverb of time. Yesterday I met my best friend is also adverb of time. The only thing is the placement of the word yesterday is different. In one sentence, it is at the beginning of a sentence. And whereas in the other one, it is written immediately after at the end of the sentence. Okay, so here examples are also given and one sentences are given written about how to use them and how to place them. So just go through these directions and attempt this question. You have to make a meaningful sentence and keep in mind where the adverbs are to be placed. Okay, so all the best for your homework.